once saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found. Was blind, but now I see. 'Twas my heart to fear, and grace
Son and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. Welcome everybody to our Mass this morning. It's the 16th Sunday of the year, and some of our parishioners of course have joined the annual pilgrimage to Lourdes, so Annie's one of them, so there's no children's liturgy this morning, and in fact the choir and children's liturgy are going to have the month of August off, so sort of just like the MPs in Parliament, you know. So, to prepare ourselves then to celebrate the Mass together, let's call to mind our sins. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do. Through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of good will. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you. We give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray. Show favor, Lord, to your servants, and mercifully increase the gifts of your grace, that made fervent in hope, faith, and charity, they may be ever watchful in keeping your commands. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
Reading from the Book of Wisdom. There is no God other than you who cares for everything, to whom you might have to prove that you never judged unjustly. Your justice has its source in strength. Your sovereignty over all makes you lenient to all. You show your strength when your sovereign power is questioned, and you expose the insolence of those who know it. But disposing of such strength, you are mild in judgment. You govern us with great lenience, for you only have to will, and your power is there. By acting thus, you have taught a lesson to your people, how the virtuous man must be kindly to his fellow men, and you have given your sons the good hope that after sin you will grant repentance. The word of the Lord. The response to the psalm is, O Lord, you are good and forgiving. O Lord, you are good and forgiving, full of love to all who call. Give heed, O Lord, to my prayer, and attend the sound of my voice. O Lord, you are good and forgiving. All the nations shall come to adore you and glorify your name, O Lord. For you are great and do marvellous deeds, you who alone are God. O Lord, you are good and forgiving. But you, God of mercy and compassion, slow to anger, O Lord, abounding in love and truth, turn and take pity on me. O Lord, you are good and forgiving. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. The Spirit comes to help us in our weakness, for when we cannot choose words in order to pray properly, the Spirit himself expresses our plea in a way that could never be put into words. And God, who knows everything in our hearts, knows perfectly well what he means, and that the pleas of the saints expressed by the Spirit are according to the mind of God. The word of the Lord. May the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ enlighten the eyes of our mind so that we can see what hope his call holds for us.
Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus put a parable before the crowds. The kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seed in his field. While everybody was asleep, his enemy came, sowed darnel among the wheat, and made off. When the new wheat sprouted and ripened, the darnel appeared as well. The owner's servants went to him and said, "Sir, was it not good seed that you sowed in your field? If so, where does the darnel come from?" "Some enemy has done this," he answered. And the servant said, "Do you want us to go and weed it out?" But he said, "No, because when you weed out the darnel, you might pull up the wheat with it. Let them both grow till the harvest, and at harvest time I shall say to the reapers, 'First collect the darnel and tie it in bundles to be burnt, and then gather the wheat into my barn.'" Then leaving the crowds, he went to the house, and his disciples came to him and said, "Explain the parable about the darnel in the field to us." He said in reply, "The sower of the good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed is the subjects of the kingdom, the darnel the subjects of the evil one. The enemy who sowed them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the world. Reapers are the angels. Well then, just as the darnel is gathered up and burnt in the fire, so it will be at the end of time. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will gather out of his kingdom all things that provoke offenses and all who do evil, and throw them into the blazing furnace, where there will be weeping and grinding of teeth. Then the virtuous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Listen, anyone who has ears." The Gospel of the Lord. Good morning, all. On Thursday at... Must be a sin to drop the good book, I'm not sure about that. On Thursday at Bible Share, we started the book of Ezekiel, which is full of mystical poetry, and to be honest, had some of us scratching our heads as to its meaning. But in a nutshell, Ezekiel was told by God to take a warning to his people who'd been behaving in a despicable way, that unless they turned back to him, they would be annihilated. It was a pretty crude but effective way of grabbing their attention. But in today's reading from the Book of Wisdom, we see a very different understanding about the way that God deals with his people. "You are mild in judgment, and you govern us with great lenience." Both Ezekiel and Wisdom, in their different ways, point to God's desire not to lose anybody. And both of them profess that forgiveness and mercy await even the most recalcitrant of sinners who do turn back to him. And this is the theme that Jesus takes up in the Gospel. When the workers discover that thorns are growing alongside his precious wheat, they report it to the farmer and advise him that action must be taken immediately to root them out. But as we see, he disagrees with them because he wants to give the wheat every possible chance. In spite of the thorns, he knows there'll still be a good crop of wheat. And when Jesus explains the parable to the apostles, he likens it to the Last Judgment, when evildoers will be separated from the good and each will be assigned their fate. However, as with all Jesus' parables, more to them meets the eye. It's not just about the final judgment. It's also about how we live our lives on a daily basis. So the desire of the workers to root out and throw away the darnel highlights the difference between the way that God deals with people deemed as unacceptable and the way that we do. It's a rather disturbing trait of human nature, I think, that to play the judge and decide who is worthy or not. So, for example, a tabloid press strives on painting public figures as hypocrites or splashing their sexual misadventures across the front page, as we've seen recently with Hugh Edwards. Social media is very quick to condemn without knowing all the facts. And our woke culture allows people of one view to cancel others whose views don't match up with theirs, as Coutts Bank has just done this week with Nigel Farage. It's almost as though they're somehow trying to create an idealized community of the perfect by getting rid of the dross. But God, on the other hand, refuses to write anyone off, always keeping in mind their potential to change. And he knows that very few people are totally bad. And what's more, being allowed to grow up alongside the wheat may just provide the chance of some goodness to rub off on them. And the key thing to remember is that God has all the time in the world, and he's prepared to wait as long as it takes for someone to turn back to him. It's never too late to repent and seek forgiveness, no matter what we've done. As the Book of Wisdom says, there is no other God other than you who cares for everything. You are all powerful, and your sovereign power is unquestioned. And it's precisely because God is all powerful that nothing can disturb his equilibrium. Nothing has the power to change him from being an all-loving God for every person he has created, even those who have chosen evil. He's the living embodiment of the phrase, hate the sin, love the sinner. So I suppose you could call the world that we live a field that's full of ambiguities and complexities in which good and evil coexist and therefore need the art of discernment. Even the church, as we know so well, is made up of saints and sinners, those who live exemplary lives and those who certainly do not. But for those of us who do not belong to the idealist community of the perfect, we may have to accept from time to time some fraternal correction along the way, like the people Ezekiel had to warn, but not quite in the same scary way as he did it. We are a mixed bag for sure, but our Father loves each and every one of his children, and he'll never stop trying to seek them out, always watching the road for the prodigal son to return. But at the heart of the parable is the message to leave the outcome to God and refrain from judging others harshly, because we can never know what's in their hearts or what they may be going through at this particular time. To know all is to forgive all, and remember, there but for the grace of God go I. Let us stand now and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Father, as always, we thank you so much for all you've given for us, especially your Son Jesus, who taught us so much about not judging and trying to see the best in everybody. And we pray for a fresh outpouring of the Holy Spirit to help us to do that as we now put before you our prayers.
We pray for Francis our Pope, Paul our Bishop, all priests and religious, especially Father Alf, that by their leadership and example, they may continue to guide the Church along the right path as Jesus intended. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
As our schools, colleges and universities break up for the summer holidays, we pray that both pupils and teachers enjoy this time of rest and relaxation and return refreshed and motivated in September. We pray especially for those pupils who are moving on to senior school, sixth form college or university. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
Let us pray for our friend of this parish, Stephen Bamber, as he continues his journey to the priesthood. He has just completed his first year of study in Rome. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those in our parish who are sick and are unable to attend Mass in church. May they, joining us by live streaming and regular communion visits by our great team of Eucharistic ministers, keep them at the heart of our parish family. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all our relatives and friends who have gone before us to the eternal reward. We pray especially for John Drake, who has died recently. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
If anyone has a prayer or intention that they would like to share, please raise your hand and a microphone will be brought to you. We place all our prayers and intentions into the care of our Mother Mary as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now, and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Amen.
Father, as always, we thank you for so many graces and blessings in our lives and for listening to our prayers this morning. We ask you to grant them through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord, wash away my iniquity, cleanse me from all my sins. Amen. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. O God, who in the one perfect sacrifice brought to completion varied offerings of the law, accept, we pray, this sacrifice from your faithful servants, and make it holy as you bless the gifts of Abel, so that what each has offered to the honour of you may benefit the salvation of all, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body, we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna . We give you praise, Father most holy, for you are great and have fashioned all your works in wisdom and love. You formed man in your own image and entrusted the whole world to his care, so that in serving you alone, the Creator, he might have dominion over all creatures. And when, through disobedience, he had lost your friendship, you did not abandon him to the domain of death, for you came in mercy to the aid of all, so that those who seek might find you. Time and again you offered them covenants, and through the prophets taught them to look forward to salvation. And you so loved the world, Father most holy, that in the fullness of time you sent your only begotten Son to be our Saviour. Made incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, he shared our human nature in all things but sin. To the poor he proclaimed the good news of salvation, to prisoners freedom, and to the sorrowful of heart joy. To accomplish your plan, he gave himself up to death, and rising from the dead, he destroyed death and restored life, and that we might live no longer for ourselves, but for him who died and rose again for us, he sent the Holy Spirit from you, Father, as the first fruits for those who believe, so that bringing to perfection his work in the world, he might sanctify creation to the full. Therefore, Lord, we pray, may this same Holy Spirit graciously sanctify these offerings, that they may become the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, for the celebration of this great mystery, which he himself left us as an eternal covenant. For when the hour had come for him to be glorified by you, Father most holy, having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end, and while they were at supper, he took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, taking the chalice filled with wine, he gave thanks and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again. Therefore, Lord, as we now celebrate the memorial of our redemption, we remember Christ's death and his descent to the realm of the dead. We proclaim his resurrection and ascension to your right hand, and as we await his coming again in glory, we offer you his body and blood, the sacrifice acceptable to you, which brings salvation to the whole world. Look, Lord, upon the sacrifice which you yourself have provided for your church, and grant in your loving kindness to all who partake of this one bread and one cup, that gathered into one body by the Holy Spirit, they may truly become a living sacrifice in Christ to the praise of your glory. Therefore, Lord, remember now all for whom we offer this sacrifice, especially your servant Francis, our Pope, Paul, our Bishop, the whole order of bishops, all the clergy, those who take part in this offering, those gathered here before you, your entire people, and all who seek you with a sincere heart. Remember also those who have died in the peace of Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. To all of us, your children, grant, O merciful Father, that we may enter into a heavenly inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and with your apostles and saints in your kingdom. There, with the whole of creation, freed from the corruption of sin and death, may we glorify you through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let's pray now with confidence to the Father in the words our Saviour gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Peace be with you, God. Peace be with you. Peace be with you, Amen. Peace be with you, Mary. Peace be with you, Poppy. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ, Joseph. The body of Christ, Almond. body of Christ, Mary. The body of Christ, Bobby. The body of Christ, Adrian. The body of Christ, Mick. The body of Christ, Harry. Body of Christ, Susan. The body of Christ, Sheila. The body of Christ. The blessing of Christ, Jasmine. The body of Christ, Jamie. Body of Christ, Jack. The body of Christ, Dom. The body of Christ, Jean. Body of Christ, Paula. The body of Christ, you see? The body of Christ. Well done. Body of Christ, Tracy. Body of Christ, Judith. Body of Christ, Brian. The body of Christ, Pat. The body of Christ, Sheila. Body of Christ, Keith. The body of Christ, Sue. The body of Christ, Alan. Body of Christ, Jean. The body of Christ, Jane. The body of Christ, David. The body of Christ, Dan. The body of Christ, Deborah. Body of Christ, Kim. The body of Christ, Keith. The body of Christ, Joanna. The body of Christ, Beth. The body of Christ, Alan. The body of Christ, Pat. Body of Christ, Chris. The body of Christ. The body of Christ, Mallow. The body of Christ, Claire. The body of Christ, the body of Christ, Joe, the body of Christ, Mike, the body of Christ, the body of Christ, John, the blessing of Christ, the blessing of Christ, the body of Christ, Julia, the body of Christ, Terry. The body of Christ, Lynn. The body of Christ, Emma. The blessing of Christ. The body of Christ, Dominic. The body of Christ, Michelle. The body of Christ, Maureen. The body of Christ, Glenda. Body of Christ, Alan. The blessing of Christ, Mother. The blessing of Christ, the body of Christ, Joe. The body of Christ, Mike. The body of Christ, Maria. The body of Christ, Karen. The body of Christ, Pete. The body of Christ, Irene. The body of Christ, man. The body of Christ. The body of Christ, Taylor. Thank you. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, Lord, and lead those who have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. I think the bulletin is fairly self-explanatory this week. One thing I would recommend, though, is if you look at the parish ministries, there's an up-to-date list of all the people to consult if you'd like to join in any of those activities that go on in the parish, any ministries, service, etc. Obviously, it's perhaps not the best time because we're all having a bit of a relaxed time now, aren't we, for the summer? But building up for the new term in September, it'd be good for you to have a look and see if there's any of those that you fancy. And I'm reminded again to, as we go out, you know, to give a wave to all our people who are watching on live stream. I usually forget every week. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended. Let's go in peace to love and serve the Lord. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hand has made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods, and hear the brook, and hear the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross, my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great.